Hey guys, welcome back to ASP.NET MVC tutorial. I am Ashish. So this is part 30 of this video series. Before proceeding, please watch part 29 in order to apply the client-side validation using jQuery. Okay, so now in this tutorial, I'm gonna discuss about how can you return more than one model to a view. Okay, so this is very important question for the interview perspective. Okay, because usually we just return only one model to a view. Then how it can be possible to return more than one model to a view. Okay, so we will see it practically. So before starting, please do subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed. Okay, so let's get started here. So here in the previous tutorial, I have just created this form and just applied the client-side validation. So let's have the view of it. So here when I click on my login button, then it will show me the error message. Okay, now here is my index page. Okay, so let's stop it and just move to the index method. So now here I will return multiple model. Okay, so first I will just create two models. First, model A and model B. So let's say model A and then again I will just add another model, that is model B. Okay, and let's add some value, some properties inside this. So public, let's say string name. Okay, and get set. Okay, and just copy that, and inside your model B just add the property, let's say country. Okay, now let's suppose I want to return the list of model A and model B. Okay, so I will just create an object for a list object for model A. Okay, so let's say list underscore A equal to new list. Okay, and similarly just create another list for model B, that is model B, and let's say list underscore B. Okay, and now add item to list A and list B. Okay, so first I will add some item in list A. So list A dot add. So here you can add the model A, and curly braces, if you put space then you can find the property name. So property name equal to Ashish. Okay, so first item is added, and now add two more items, that is here, and you can see John and Sarah. Okay, similarly I will add some item in list B also. Okay, so list.add new of model B. Okay, and here you will find your country property. So country equal to, let's say US. UK. And add another property, another country like India. Okay, so I have added three items in both lists. Okay, and now I just need to return this list to this view. Okay, so I will just create another model, that is, let's say model C. So that is the big deal, and that is the main idea about this. How can you return multiple model? So here I will just create the list of this that two item. So list of model A, that is list, let's say list A get set. Okay, let's say just name it, let's say, and public. Now create the list of model B. Okay, so list B get set. Okay, or you can define another property like list string age get set. Okay, so this is your model C, and you can return this model C to your view. So that's the main idea behind it. So let's go to controller and just create the object of model C. Okay, C final item equal to new model C. Okay, so my final item dot, you can find your age, and here you can find your list A item, list B item. So your list A equals, you can just pass this item to list A. Okay, and again final item dot list B equal to list B. Okay, and for your property, last property, that is age, you can add any int, but I have taken is string, so you can make it, let's say 12. Okay, and go to your, just change the return type, so it's int. Okay, and now finally I will just return this final item to my view. Okay, and now for accessing that, you just need to go to your index, and instead of this model I will use my model C. Okay, so here the left part would be same, and on the right side I will just display the list from both model. Okay, so let's delete that image. And first thing is that you just need to just check whether this model is null or not. So it should not be null. So it's just check is not equal to null, then perform some action. Okay, so create div and class, let's say call md6. Okay, and now copy that also, and here let's try to write some text here, Ashish, and here Tivari, and let's try to run. So here you can see the item. So I will show my list model A data and model B data there. So here you go, and here I will display my model A data and here model B data. So Now div created, instead of div you can just take the unordered list, and you can just use @ for each item or where, let's say name equal to in your iteration. So model dot, now here you can see your list, so list A, and you can create list and just add a class. So I'm just adding the bootstrap class, that is a list group, and in list I will just use the list group item. Okay, and here I will just display the name. So name dot @name dot. Okay, so I will just see name. Okay, and similarly I will just create the another list for showing my countries. And here you can say, so in this case I will just use this display list B. Okay, and here instead of name I will just use the country dot, so use here country dot country. Okay, now save it. And here you also have your age data, that is you can use here, that is model dot age. Okay, now reload that. So here you can see your both model data, model A and then model B, and here you can see your age. Okay, so just put it inside the h4 tag. Okay, now save it and reload that. Okay, so in this way you can return multiple models to a view. So it's a very good question, and for the interview perspective it is very fantastic question interviewer may ask you. Okay, so similarly if you can display the data from the model, and instead of displaying data you can also create a form. Suppose if you want to create a big form, like the name for the employee information and for the its address information, you can just separate them. Okay, so you can also define multiple text boxes for different model. Okay, so here is the concept. So I hope you understand this. So I am done here. So if you like my video, then give it a thumbs up, and if you have any query then please do comment, and please do subscribe my channel, and share among your friends. Okay, so thank you very much, have a great day.